Hi, it's me Tina Amir and welcome to my channel. So for today, we're going to learn about kata bantu or in English, helping words. This is part one, but before I begin for this video, I'm just going to use informal pronunciation. For those of you who are still not clear yet what is informal pronunciation, please watch my number 53 video, which is about confusing pronunciation. Today's topic is about kata bantu. So kata is word, bantu is help. So kata bantu is helping words. This is part one. So what is kata bantu? Kata bantu are the words that present to help the predicate of a sentence. So, it's present before the frasa kerja or frasa adjective or frasa sendi nama. Before I did this kind of video, but very brief, I will give you link in the comment section below. Please check them out. However, for this time, I'm going to go more detail about it. And we're going to have three videos about this topic, three parts. So, this is part one, kata bantu aspek. So, kata bantu aspek related with time. Okay, or in Malay we say berkaitan dengan masa. So, related berkaitan dengan with masa is time. And then the part two, the second topic is about kata bantu ragam. Ragam is manner. So, basically it's related with feelings and behavior. Berkaitan dengan perasaan dan perbuatan. So, berkaitan related with dengan feeling, perasaan and dan perbuatan is behavior. And part 3 will be combinations of both. So, for this one, I will explain one by one. Okay, for this video is about kata bantu aspek. Under kata bantu aspek, there will be 3 categories. First one, masa lampau. Masa is time, lampau is past. So, the past is masa lampau. So, basically, masa lampau is something sudah dilakukan. So, sudah is already, dilakukan is done. So, masa lampau, the past, sudah dilakukan, already done. And then, number two, masa kini, masa time. Kini is now. So, masa kini refer to the present. So, sedang dilakukan. Sedang is like in the process and dilakukan is done. So, basically, is doing. Okay, because it's present. So, is doing. And number three, masa hadapan. Future. So, masa is time. Hadapan is like front. So, basically, masa hadapan is future. Which means akan dilakukan. So, akan is will. Dilakukan is here, done. So, it's like will be done. I'm going to explain the first one. Masa lampau or the past, which means sudah dilakukan, sudah already, dilakukan, done. So, sudah dilakukan, already done. So, under this category, there will be 4 words. Telah, sudah, pernah, baru. Telah, sudah, pernah, baru. So, we start with the first one, telah. Telah means already. So, I give for my example here. Sungai itu telah kering airnya. Sungai itu telah kering airnya. In English, the water of that river already dry. So, sungai is river, itu is that, telah is already, kering is dry, air is water. Airnya refer to that sungai, so it's water basically. I only include formal and English example. There's no for speaking because telah normally we don't like to use it for daily conversation as it sounds too formal for us. Next one, sudah. Sudah also means already. So I give example here. This is formal Malay. Lulu sudah menyiapkan semua kerja sekolahnya. Lulu sudah menyiapkan semua kerja sekolahnya. So, in English, Lulu already did all her homeworks. So, Lulu sudah already menyiapkan from the root word siap, done. So, menyiapkan is prefix menuai plus the root word siap plus the suffixkan. Menyiapkan semua or kerja, work, sekolah is school, sekolahnya, her school. So, her homeworks basically because it's kerja sekolahnya, right? So, Lulu sudah menyiapkan semua kerja sekolahnya. For this one, I include speaking part because we really use sudah for daily conversation. But we say, Lulu dah siapkan semua kerja sekolah dia. Lulu dah siapkan semua kerja sekolah dia. So, Lulu dah, sudah, we shorten to dah. Menyiapkan, we shorten to siapkan semua kerja sekolah dia. So, instead of we say sekolahnya, we say sekolah dia. Okay, that's about sudah. So, next word is pernah. 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 Okay, so pernah is ever. Pernah also means already or be related in a certain way. I give formal Malay example here. Lily pernah ke Pulau Tioman 5 tahun lepas. Lily pernah ke Pulau Tioman 5 tahun lepas. So in English, Lily had been to Pulau Tioman or Tioman Island 5 years ago. So Lily pernah, pernah ke here is had been to. Okay? Pulau Tioman 5, 5, tahun is years, lepas is past. So, 5 tahun lepas is 5 years ago. However, for speaking, we say, Lily pernah pergi Pulau Tioman 5 tahun lepas. Lily pernah pergi Pulau Tioman 5 tahun lepas. Instead of we say the word ke for to, we like to say the word pergi, pergi. So, pergi is go. So, Lily pernah pergi Pulau Tioman 5 tahun lepas. Last word for masa lampau or the past, baru. Baru. So, baru means new. That is common meaning of baru. But the meaning for this one is just or recent. So, former Malay, Ali baru pulang dari Singapura. Ali baru pulang dari Singapura. So, in English it means Ali just returned from Singapore. So, Ali baru, Ali just, pulang is return, from is dari. However, for speaking, we say Ali baru balik dari Singapore. Ali baru balik dari Singapore. So, pulang and balik basically synonym. Just balik we prefer to use for daily conversation. And instead of we say Singapura, we like to say Singapore. So now I'm moving on to the second category, masa kini, which means present. So in another word is sedang dilakukan, doing, right? Sedang is in the process and dilakukan is done, so means doing. So, under this category, masa kini, we have three words. Masih, sedang, mula. Masih, sedang, mula. So, I start with the first word, masih. Masih means still or yet. So, this is formal Malay example. Abu masih bermain di padang walaupun hujan lebat. Abu masih bermain di padang walaupun hujan lebat. So, in English it means Abu is still playing on the field despite heavy rains. So, Abu masih still, masih bermain, is still playing. So, bermain, the root word here is main, play. Di, in or on. Padang is field walaupun despite. Hujan is rain, lebat is actually thick, but hujan lebat is heavy rain. So, Abu masih bermain di padang walaupun hujan lebat. However, for speaking, we don't say something like that. We just say, Abu masih main kat padang walaupun hujan lebat. Abu masih main kat padang walaupun hujan lebat. So, instead of we use the word bermain, we shorten to main. And then instead of we say the word di, we replace it with the word kat. Kat padang. So, that's basically about the word masih. Now, we move on to the second word of the present, sedang. Sedang. So, sedang means in the process, in the middle of something. So, this is formal Malay example. Budak itu sedang mendengar music dan menari. Budak itu sedang mendengar music dan menari. So, in English it means that kid is listening to music and dancing. So, budak is kid. Budak itu that kid. Sedang mendengar. So, mendengar, the root word here is dengar, listen. So, sedang mendengar is listening. Music is music, dan and menari from the root word tari, dance. So, menari is dancing. Okay? So, budak itu sedang mendengar music dan menari. However, for speaking, we say, budak tu tengah dengar music dan menari. Or, budak tu tengah dengar music dan berjoget. So, instead of we say the word itu, we shorten to tu. Instead of we say the word sedang, we use the word tengah. Tengah means middle. So, it means in the middle of. So, instead of you use the word sedang, please remember you use the word tengah. So, instead of you say the word mendengar, you shorten it to dengar. And for menari, people don't say tari, people say menari. And the other synonym of it is berjoget. So, the root word here is joget. I repeat again, budak tu tengah dengar music dan menari. Budak tu tengah dengar music dan berjoget. Last one for present or masa kini. Last word is mula. Mula. So, mula means begin, first or start. So, I give formal example here and also for speaking. Nini mula sakit tekak sejak semalam. Nini mula sakit tekak sejak semalam. So, in English it means Nini started to have sore throat since yesterday. So, Nini mula, Nini started to have in bracket because in Malay you just don't need that. Sakit is pain or sore here. Tekak is throat. So, sakit tekak is sore throat. Sejak is since. Semalam is, se is one or satu. Malam is night. Semalam means one night. Semalam here means yesterday. So, Nini mula sakit tekak sejak semalam. Now, we move on to the last category of this kata bantu aspek. So, for the third one, masa hadapan. So, masa hadapan is future. So, under masa hadapan, we have two words, akan and belum. So, we start with the first one, akan. Akan means will. So, I give formal example here. Nani akan melawat rumah anak-anak yatim pada petang ini. Nani akan melawat rumah anak-anak yatim pada petang ini. English example. Nani will be visiting orphanage this afternoon. So, Nani akan is will, melawat from the root word lawat. Visit, rumah is house, anak is the word for son or daughter or kid. So, anak-anak is children, anak yatim is orphan. So, anak-anak yatim is orphan. So, rumah anak-anak yatim is orphanage. Pada on, petang, afternoon, ini is this. Nani akan melawat rumah anak-anak yatim pada petang ini. However, for speaking, we don't say something like that. We just say, Nani akan lawat rumah anak-anak yatim petang ni. Nani akan lawat rumah anak-anak yatim petang ni. Some people also use the word visit. So, Nani akan visit rumah anak-anak yatim petang ni. Or, without akan, you may also say, Nani lawat rumah anak-anak yatim petang ni. For akan, we can just drop it because petang ni already means future. So, even without akan, it already means future. So, you don't have to for regular conversation. People will understand. But if you want to say, then it's up to you. That's also okay. Okay, now we move on to the last one, belum. Belum is not yet or not. So, from a Malay sentence, air yang dijerang itu belum mendidih lagi. Air yang dijerang itu belum mendidih lagi. In English, it means water that is heated is not boiling yet. So basically, air means water. Yang is that. Dijerang from the root word jerang. So what is jerang actually? Jerang is when you put pot or kettle on the fire to cook or to boil. So we call this as jerang. So, when you jerang something, normally you expecting it to boil. Itu is that, belum is not yet or not. Mendidih from the root word didih, boil. Lagi means yet here. So, air yang dijerang itu belum mendidih lagi. But however, for speaking, we just say, air yang jerang tu belum mendidih lagi. Or, some people also say, air yang jerang tu belum didih lagi. So, mendidih here, some people also use the word mendidih with prefix for speaking. But some people also skip that. Doesn't matter. So, instead of we say dijerang, the passive form, we just say jerang. Tu from the word itu, which means that. Air yang jerang tu belum mendidih lagi. Or, air yang jerang tu belum didih lagi. I guess that's all our lesson for now. Thank you very much for watching me. And if you like my video, please check out my Patreon page so that I can have more time to make more videos. For those of you who support me through this medium, thank you very much. I really appreciate that. And for those of you who's watching me right now, thank you very much. And till we meet again then. Bye!